Good morning. Welcome to The Morning Touch. I'm Darwin Campbell. Today we're going to talk about greatness. Greatness. Defining greatness. That's always been an age-old debate. Greatness. What is it that makes Hall of Fame lives, Hall of Fame careers? Greatness. What is it that causes men and women to debate? Who's number one? Greatness. Greatness based on achievement. Greatness based on talent. So we're going to talk about that today. Freedom Friday. Greatness. And how do I play into the recipe and the ingredients of greatness? Stand by. The Morning Touch is brought to you by the Chapter for the Homeless and the FSBC in Glendale. Greatness. We'll be right back. You know, when we think about greatness, we talk about such things, or what comes to mind. Tom Brady just retired a couple of days ago. 7 Super Bowls, 7 rings. They call him the GOAT, the greatest of all time. Well, in football, he's considered the greatest of all time. None like him, no other athlete like him in this era of mankind in history. Tom Brady, the GOAT. But I can think of some other who were considered the greatest of all time. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time in the boxing circles. Hank Aaron, Babe Ruth, the greatest of all time. Home run kings, home run hitters. In the Hall of Fame, remembered forever for their greatness on the baseball field. How about Michael Jordan? Who could forget? One of the greatest basketball players of all time. Scoring records, moves like madness, championships in Chicago. Or what about LeBron James in modern times? My friends, greatness is something that we aspire. Greatness is something that we admire. Greatness is something that we debate. We sit around on general store porches. We sit around in backyards at barbecues and we argue and discuss and we debate greatness. But my friends, there's something I want us to look at today. When we talk about greatness, I want us to go into the Word of God. Because there I believe we find the ultimate definition of greatness. You know, I like to put it like this. Men achieve greatness, but God defines it. Men achieve greatness with the feats and the talents and the skill sets that they have in their sports, in their politics. You think about greatness, Abraham Lincoln and what he was able to do during the Civil War. That's greatness. We think about John F. Kennedy, what he was able to do, Cuban Missile Crisis, bring us back from nuclear war in the 60s. That's greatness. So there's sports greatness, there's political greatness, there's life achievement greatness. But my friends, as we debate greatness, I can't help but think about how mankind over centuries has debated this very thing. Even in the New Testament, there was an argument about who was the greatest. Amongst the disciples, who is the greatest? Lord, they asked, who is the greatest among us? I'm Peter, I'm James, I'm John, I'm Philip, I'm Bartholomew. Look at what I'm doing. Amongst us, Lord, point out who's the greatest. The Bible says there was also strife among them, which of them should be accounted as the greatest. Jesus says, but he that is greatest among you, let him be the younger, Let him be that chief who does serve. Jesus says, I am among you, and I am he that serves. Jesus sent a strong message. Greatness is not always about accomplishment. Greatness is not always about achieving some feat, the Hall of Fame in sports, or some great political move, or some great civic achievement. Greatness in the Bible is attributed to our ability to reach down and to come down and to serve. Greatness is attributed to our ability to serve. Jesus says, you're not great just because you can hit a ball out of the park 500-600 feet. You're not great because you can score 83 points in a basketball game. You're not great because you knock out everybody that steps into the ring against you. You're not great because you stand there before America at a fireside chat or at a speech and talk about how powerful and glorious and great America is. You're not great because you've got 7 Super Bowl rings on your fingers. You are great when you can come down and reach down and humble yourself and serve the person right next to you. You are great when you can give of yourself, not have the accolades poured upon you and heaped upon you. And you stand up proud with your chest out and say, look at me. Look at who I am. Look at what I have achieved. I've got 7 rings. I've scored game after game. I've hit home runs out of the park like you wouldn't believe. My friends, Jesus talks to us about greatness. And he says greatness is not in what you do, you achieve according to your skill set. It's not about the accolades heaped upon you by men. Your greatness is defined by the same example set by Jesus himself, who said, the greatest among us is he who serves. My friends, and no one set the standard better than Jesus when it comes down to greatness. He was perfect in every way. Greatness. He set the standards for moral living. Greatness. He broke all spiritual records. Greatness. He performed great feats, healing the sick, causing the blind to see, raising the dead. Greatness, my friends, that is greatness. And these are records that will never, ever, ever be broken. No one will be able to perform the feats Jesus performed, do the things Jesus did. No one will be able to rise to the levels of service that Jesus rose, feeding 5,000 with a few fish and loaves of bread, feeding 4,000 the same way. He is the greatest of all time. And he should be in our Gospel Hall of Fame, my friends. Why? Because he did all these things yet without sin. Hebrews 4:15. Why? Because he demonstrated the example of a servant as defined in Matthew 23:11. And even more so, Jesus is in our spiritual hall of fame because this servant humbled himself, served God, completed his task, said, Father, it is finished. I have completed the task. Those things that you've asked me, not my will, but thy will be done. Jesus, the humble servant, teaches us it's not about the feats that we can accomplish or the things that we can do or the accolades that are heaped upon us. It's not about being in the Hall of Fame, hitting home runs, getting Super Bowl rings. It's not about knocking people out. It's about how many people have I humbled myself to and I serve. That makes you great, my friends. This great debate over greatness should not be a debate at all. You are great when you reach out and you reach down and you lift up someone who needs your love, who needs your support, who needs your encouragement. You are great when you do that, my friends. Jesus taught us how to be great. And he is the ultimate example of greatness. He is the greatest of all time. My friends, let us understand. One of his greatest roles that he served was one of advocate. The Bible says in 1 John, we learn, chapter 2, verses 1 and 2. The Bible tells us that this Jesus is one who is an advocate. The Bible clearly tells us that he is the advocate. He advocates for you and I. His greatest role ever, my little children. If any man sin, we have an advocate, the Father. Jesus stands there at the Father's presence, in his presence, and he says, it's about Darwin. It's about Susan. It's about Michael. It's about Billy. It's about Okakaru, whoever his name is. It's about that. Listen, he's the advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, not only for ours, but for the sins of the world. We have someone standing there advocating, talking. We have an attorney, Jesus Christ. He is the propitiation, the substitution. He is our voice with the Father and to the Father. My friends, the greatest of all time, the servant, the greatest of all time. The humble one who gave his life for our sins. The greatest of all time. The one who shows us the way, the truth, and the life. The greatest of all time. How can we argue with one who has performed these great feats? With one who has broken all the records? The one who has set the standard? The one who advocates for us while we could not save ourselves? Lost. Romans 5:8, Christ died for the ungodly. That's you and that's me. My friends, he is the greatest of all time because he teaches us love. He teaches us service. He teaches us that we ought not to think more highly of ourselves than we ought to think, no matter what we've done. 7 Super Bowl rings, so what? The greatest score of all time in basketball, so what? The greatest home run king ever, so what? Jesus Christ, the propitiation for our sins, the advocate with the Father, hallelujah. Home runs can't save you. Super Bowl rings can't save you. Scoring and knocking people out can't save you. But Jesus Christ, the advocate who speaks for us before the Father, that's a real home run. Now that's a knockout. Jesus Christ, the greatest of all time. Our time is gone, but I just want you to fully understand where we are today. The fact of the matter is, this Jesus is one that we can afford to ignore. We need to understand that he is with us. And we need to understand that he is able to rescue us. He is the greatest of all time. Servant, advocate, while we sit around and argue about the greatest is already here. Matthew chapter 3, verses 17. This is my beloved Son, whom I well pleased. Hear ye him. Jesus Christ, the greatest of all time, greater than Brady, greater than Muhammad Ali, greater than Babe Ruth, greater than Michael Jordan, greater than Hank Aaron, greater than Martin Luther King Jr. This Jesus, my advocate, my servant, this Jesus, the one who stands and stood and died for me, he is the definition of true, true greatness. The Morning Touch, brought to you by the Chaps for the Homeless and the FSBC Glendale. Go for it. Make it a great weekend this Freedom Friday. And remember who is the greatest. God bless you.